hotel. Left you sleeping alone in your bed. I guess I did let you down. In a wake up state and out too late, trying to start over new. What I wanted to be never came to me. Lost my way to you.
I like to call it stop and smell the roses. I like to stop and I like to take pictures of the surrounding area. And I'm using the front and rear camera of my dash cam to kind of switch back and forth for views going uphill, as well as the beautiful views that I can capture through the rear camera lens.
Psychology in a different way to live.
As I captioned earlier, I'm running a portion of the Alpine Loop where it meets up with the Engineer Pass, headed towards Lake City. And usually whenever I'm driving, I drive with my music playing, so that's why I had to cut out the sound for most of this video. The last pass video that I uploaded was Ophir-Silverton Pass, not far from where I am, but definitely a different run. In fact, at the time, I thought that the Ophir-Silverton Pass was a relatively difficult one. Man, I tell you, the Alpine Loop here, at least the portion that I was on, was extremely easy compared to the Ophir-Silverton Pass. And the Engineer Pass put the Ophir-Silverton Pass to shame. In fact, it's a pass I probably won't run again, at least not with all of my equipment and everything. It was not something that I was actually prepared for, but I do have enough experience, obviously, to go ahead and complete it. As a courtesy, I like to give the opportunity for the individuals that are going a little faster than me to pass me, because I'm in no hurry.
Be my friend. I know that discomfort.
And now for a little bit of snow melt and ASMR break. Part of the reason that I take it as slow as I do is because, as you can see, there's a little bit of side-to-side movement, and I want to make sure that I don't disrupt or dislodge my build on my way up the mountain.
No, I'm
got the thumbs up as confirmation that I'm allowing him to pass.
Forgiven.
There was quite a bit of traffic on the Alpine Loop portion of this, and most of the people wanted to be on the Alpine Loop, which brings you back around to the Million Dollar Road just north of Silverton. No reason for me to take this pass coming from Montrose, because the Million Dollar Road was more than enough. At this point, I took a little moment for pause because the road looked a lot better going in the direction that most of these vehicles are coming from, but my map was telling me to go straight. And as I started to look up that hill and I started to look at the mountain to the left, which you'll see as I go past these trees, well, let's just say it was at this point that I made a commitment to continue, and it wasn't an easy one.
And whisper your words like secrets written in an old moleskin. And look up above, the sunlight seems.
As you can see, the washout becomes a lot more evident, and the road narrows considerably. And believe it or not, this is actually a lot wider than a couple of sections I'm going to come to in a little bit. You'll see. It got a little bit daunting. The views themselves, though, were definitely something that kept me going. I really did want to see not only the rest of this run, but I wanted to make it to the summit just to see what it looked like from up top.
Turn off the lights, the stars in the sky are turning so clear. And without the words, the feelings unheard can still be just as sincere. Something's not right. Something ain't right. Oh, something ain't right. Something ain't
right about now, I started to see the challenge that I had coming up. I'm going to freeze frame here, and you can actually see the switchbacks that I have to look forward to as I continue to rise up this mountain. As the road continues to narrow, I come across my first switchback, and it turns out to be a pretty good challenge. I end up having to back off a little bit and let another vehicle go through, checking their clearance just to see exactly what line I need to take. I ended up being right on the initial line that I took, but as you can see, whenever I do actually take that line, the road in front of me just disappears.
Rusty red on her shoulder, I was cleaning her shoe. When it clicked on, I tried over in the bright morning dew. We brushed and we braided dandelions and chewed. It was a mutual arrangement we both saw into.
In many cases, whenever you go over these passes, you see the signs that say that they don't do any maintenance, especially during the winter. And even in the spring, with the amount of washout from snow melt, all they can really do is just try to smooth out the gravel and dirt that remains. The rocks that actually get exposed as the washout continues, well, you just have to endure that.
If she go and jump the fence, stay and what could have been. Broke my arm.
All right, so check out Mario Andretti here. This guy, it's clearly not his first rodeo on this pass. In fact, he's going to that first switchback that I just cleared, and I was watching, hoping that I didn't see him careen off of the mountain, but he just took it like a champ. I understand that there was a lot of additional snow this spring, late into the spring, and so therefore I saw a lot of snow pretty early, or at least at lower elevations than I typically would otherwise. Alright, so last chance. Alpine Pass goes straight. Engineer Pass towards Lake City. Take a right. By the way, take a look at those switchbacks. And even though I had already come across some pretty difficult switchbacks and some narrow roads, it was at this point, especially whenever I looked behind me and saw the other vehicles going on Alpine Pass, that I started to second guess my decision. But I really kind of at this point felt like I was committed and I was going to follow through with it. So for perspective, those mountains that you can see through this rear view camera are between 11 and 12,000 feet or higher, and you're looking down at them. As you can see from this large rock and the fact that I had to back up, that was pretty much the reason for my prayer. There was also something else that gave me a moment for pause, namely the fact that my tires, not all four at the same time, but all of my tires were spinning to get up over the top of these rocks.
Picture frames, lavender pain. They all live here within this romance. I get
the funny thing is that every switchback I came to, I kept thinking, man, I've got to be getting close to the summit, but I kept going higher and higher and higher. Here comes another one of those opportunities to smell the roses.
Just tell me I belong. That I'm the lucky one. I'm your chosen one.
As you can see, this is another one of those spots where there's just no way that they can try to grade this out to smooth it in any way. It's just exposed rock that you need to climb over.
Run and be the lucky one.
This is another one of those switchbacks that was a little scary for a different reason. Anyone who has ever driven on the highway knows exactly what these mean. Okay, here's an opportunity to listen to a little bit of road sound as I'm traveling up the pass. And so as I neared the summit, I started to notice that the snowpacks were getting a little larger and the edge wasn't getting any further to my left. And I started thinking, man, what if these, one of them, decided to break loose? I'm quite certain there's a little more weight to my right than I'm sitting in right now. And the hits just keep on coming.
By the road with an ache in my head, in the wrong side of town, left you sleeping. Yes, I did let you down in a wake-up state and out too late.
I was in complete awe. I had to pause here.
What I wanted to be never came to me. I've lost my way to you. I remember the words that you said when I pledged you my time. You would never get out of my head. You would always be mine. And I wake up, stay an hour too late, trying to start over new.
The trip down Engineer Pass was considerably easier than going up, so I didn't necessarily include this. I just wanted to get to the summit and show you the absolute beautiful view of the 13,000 foot mountain that I was able to climb.
By the road with an ache in my head, in the wrong side of town. Left you sleeping alone in your bed. Guess I did let you down. Jumping from cliffs so high, trusting our wings to fly. Sometimes we're crashing down, but we get up and start from the ground. I will keep on searching for my highs. You can say I lost my mind. I will keep on holding my head high. Even if the sky is falling down, even if the sky is falling down, yeah. The sky is falling down.
All the best, always.
Underground old school, there's a shovel. Can you dig it, fool?
We can dig it,
can you dig it?
We can dig it.